because we're the guy at this point, and we're just scary, we're not making the other things well. Start something away. Before someone told me it was Mother's Day, he was shut out of his room. But now I have something to say to you. So, I showed up.
is a way of building up to trust. We don't describe yourself to a project like this because it's inside. It's the biggest threat to control the different powers that it's trust. So, in fact, this is in a real sense the way that I just described before. Like, the book this year is controlled by these scripts. I pull out this slot, it looks like fuzzy, I'm not going to see it. It says move to stuff. So I click it, it says move to stuff. If I take another block, this is a particular category. And like here's one that says play and run sound. And then I choose a sound that's a symbol sound. So when I click on this block, it plays a symbol. Now the two blocks together, and I get a sequence. For example, a program having a sequence of commands. Now, if I click the stop block, it will leave it there by itself. If I want to do that repeatedly, that's what the computer is very good at doing, it's just repeatedly. I can pull out this block and just repeat playing. And I can just snap it around it. And now, when I click that, so repeatedly do that. So, you can scratch. The idea of the program is very much like snapping Lego bricks together. In fact, we're going to inspire by our work with Lego, where with Lego bricks, you get structures in the world. With Scott's programming, you get behaviors by stacking these graphical blocks together. He describes the behaviors to control your entire system. So the whole is that somehow it's already do this. You know, made this thing by stacking the blocks together to these different styles. We're going to keep score as well. Company control, there's a category called data. If I say, this is a data variable, and I give it the name score. And that creates a new set of blocks to that. It also puts a sort of monitor on the stage that says what the score is. It says score 0. And if here's a block that says change score by 1. So if I drag it off here, if I click 54 by 1, you get an outline to see it, but the score is incremented to 1 to 2. And it's still there for a moment. And then you just saw how you could use it in this program. And you took the block to change the score, and you put it in the program greatly to boost things just a little bit. So then, I start again. Every time I come back, the three cells are 3. That is 4. Some of the time, the big thing is a little bit, which is the score. So I show this to a home, and he's very excited to reach out of here. And he says, thank you, thank you, thank you. And what went through my mind was, I wondered how many outputs you could take back by this group for people to vary. And I was using that as a concept. And I think the reason that's happened is we're first going to learn about variables in school. They don't really know what they're going to be useful for. They're both useful for getting your problem right for a second good score in your exam. It's not really an effective use. They don't really know how to really make use of it in something they care about. We're fear of a whole exam of where are these variables. So it's really good to use. It's just something you really care about to play the score in this game. I think that's what we see over and over in our work with kids, whether it's with Lake Firestone, with Scribe, or in other projects. Because when kids are working with things they're deeply interested in, that's where they like work hardest, persevere through the difficulties, and learn the most for the long term, and make the deepest connections to the concept, like variables, to their counseling. When we talk to a whole, it turns out, you know, they have learned about variables in school. You have to remember it because it really is a new thing to them. So once you start using it, scratch and use it over and over, it really makes it easier to make a connection with this idea of variables. I think that's something that we see all the time as we develop new technologies. We're always saying, how can we help people make deep connections to their interests? So we always, as we develop technology, we only want to make two kinds of connections. One of them is make connections to what my mentors do or proper use are called powerful ideas. The idea of a variable is a powerful idea. We can use it in different contexts and it's just power your experience. So we want to make connections to powerful ideas. We also want to make connections to people's interests. So as we get our scratch, we try to develop it to get concepts from close to the surface for experiments as well. We also want to make sure that we connect to people's interests. And if one of the reasons for scratch's success is that people can use it, because there's a wide range of different types of projects, not just getting like this kind of business. It also Mother's Day cards or animated stories or public service announcements or virtual tours. If you look at this guy's website, they have more than 3 million projects. And there's an incredible diversity of different types of projects. And this thing that is important because it uses different people with different interests, each one of them aware of making connections to the ideas and scraps. The same way they're all using to make the best available through the community is what you're getting. How does that make connections to other ways? As we continue to expand scraps, we're always thinking, how do we connect to the latest new things that are talking to the imagination and interest? Critically, one example from the latest version of scraps, we just came out with, it was just launched last month, we call Scraps 2.0. One thing that Scraps 2.0 is that we saw that a lot of times people these days are very interested with their technology, with their problems, not just using keyboards and buttons, but in gaming, things like using the Nintendo Wii or the Microsoft Kinect. People want to use their bodies to interact with things in the world, and I think that's a trend that will continue. Generally, people are just interacting with the technology that way. They're able to create technology, create their own applications. It's like software developers sitting in a software company developing it, and the users get to interact with it. We want to empower people to be the creators to get developers creative things. So the strategy is the latest way to be out of the new programming framework so the kids can make use of the webcam. To recognize how people are moving in the world, so they can just create programs like this one. There's a program called Save the Game Program. And this is the web camera. And the web camera is made, and as I move, if I move away, the character just falls. But the program says, if the character is in the right position, so again, we want to get the power kids not just to interact with these types of games, but create them on their own. So again, if you want to take a few times like this on the back and see it start, you can see there's a block here that says, it's a new emotion on the character in the father's play of the animals. So you just do that simple master command to look at it. If you're doing immersion, it's interacting with the client on the screen. If there is, you can take some action. So that way, the process for kids to start, creating projects that others can interact with, you're using your device. Let me show one more quick example. This one, if you're just using the camera, you can also use the microphone. So here's a project where story revolves around one member of the Scratch Online community. this translation is usually for the Scribe's website, it's by Greg Gustafson. And he was one of the early participants in the Scribe's community. Now, I'm not saying this is typical of the participants, these are the active participants. But I think it's interesting to sort of see the similar type of things that one member of the community was producing and sharing with the community. So, these are just a sample of the website of some of the projects that she's created. And I want to share a few of those projects. One of the first projects that I read next to worked on was a Christmas play. Working together, because I just don't want to. And then I think this is something is something we would like to talk about with this past meeting is the sense which people have made social connections with cats and work together with others. And you can see that it's so important, and that we want to help young people develop this better situation. Helping them learn to connect with other people in their work is a critically important part. And too often when people think about thinking and learning, sometimes we come up with these images of robots thinking, the individual thinking through, or the hard work, the teacher's thought. And of course, we all do some thinking, by the way. But I think we also know a lot of our most creative work comes not from just, focusing on our own thinking, but in connecting with others. So we really want to support that. Especially when it comes to focus and your programming. Because I think oftentimes people have this image of the programmer as the lone programmer sitting by himself or herself at the keyboard with this producing something. And again, coding doesn't sometimes you work by yourself. But a lot of those creative things come with focus and programming, they play for you to interact with others. And we really want to support that Scribe. In fact, we really want the Scribe, when we launched the Scribe software, 6 years ago, in 2007, we launched the online community at the exact same time. But for us, it was really important to do more hands-on. We didn't want to connect just the programming language. We wanted the programming language integrated with the online community, right at the same website to be building. And we see so many different forms of sharing, collaboration, and learning. You see something here, people writing comments on other people's projects, people doing tutorials for others. People work on collaborative teams that they call co-labs. We have people making multiplayer role-playing games. We have lots of different people all participating and using the common to play out an extended role-playing game. But the common popular way of collaborating is Unity. On the Scribe's website, all 3 million projects are people investigate them. So by clicking on Student Scribe, you can see how other people build the program. But if you just visit it, you can start tinkering with it, you can try to make changes to it, and then you can remix it, make it your own, and make your version of it. The fact that the 3 million projects on the Scribe's website, about 3 million, are remixes, where people are building on each other's work. And we see that as a very important thing to learn. And of course, you also need to learn how to be a respectful member of the community because credit and acknowledgement to people when you do borrow from their work to get to their code and also be part of what participates in the Scribe communities with that. This is some people are usually with our Scribe and say, Scribe has stole my ideas. And then they explain that as they just Scribe community, they encourage people to build on each other's ideas. But of course, you need to credit and acknowledgement. So again, like one of my graduate students, I really wondered why my emphasis was so key to his replacement. Folks can specifically remix it in Scribe. Those are how ideas spread from person to person. Talk about their attitude towards remixing changes over time as they participate in the Scribe community. So again, we do a big round of looking at places like my graduate students, the importance of sharing and collaboration in a social style of life. My final story is about Warrior Titans. How many of you are familiar with a series of books called Warrior Titans? That's just something like 8-10% I've done. That's an incredibly popular series of books for elementary age kids. They come series of copies. It's a series of books that follow this clan of titans. I don't think there's something in popular Europe, I believe. A few years ago, I thought it was a conference that was talking about multimedia storytelling. And then I was getting ready to do my presentation. The speaker right before me was telling a story about how this was an educational publishing company. And their publishing company, as happens often these days, was working on a product that they all call it a media product. They were taking something that was successful in one media, the Warrior Titans book, and they were making it online. In a virtual world, based on the Warrior Titans. So you were starting his presentation at that point, a prototype of the Warrior Titans world, and if each person is coming, they can be represented by a word of God, and there's a big thing to display, not just for the style, but explaining how what the participation in this word of God's world would look like. And this is what he said. He said there will be hundreds of other passages as far as riches. What will happen is you will consume these value and riches, and each riches is presented as the central piece of the Greek mythology beginning to grow. And he said that one word that comes out of it was the word consuming. He said, you know, he's going to start to use this consuming value. And for me, you know, although there could be some really, you know, valuable things that we get by grasping in the world of God's world, but for me, I think I want to hear about it. It's not just interacting with someone else's work, not just interacting with someone else's manual, not just consuming the manual, but want to support kids in creating their own manual. So as he was talking, I quickly went to the God's website and got to the church. And I spoke to a warrior class, and sure enough, I got the project of warrior type, but even some values that have represented expressions of warrior type based on papers. This is a gallery that we have provided by different people in this community, all about warrior type. So this is like, you know, looking at these quickly to identify how it was possible. And some of the work projects where they allow you to, you know, create a warrior type that selects different controls and five features. And then also selecting the environment where it's going to live. There are others that were different in place of the world of the past. You can get to control one of the past, which moves the relationships you can drive with other past, you learn certain lessons, and you click on certain things, and you find that you can learn about your weapons to be used in different ways to interact with the environment. So that's all this is an environment that is beginning to plan. So I started looking at my experience with that. So this is a project that was used by 500 people, and we saw this with their own things. But also, one thing that I took away, first of all, the version series, this is a series that my friend was working on. And then I had to practice monotone, and I had to discuss it all along the length of the process. Like, some of it was just triple class, like some of it was just awesome, and my experience was great. Look at version 3, as an extra level of your life, check it out. So the advertising of the product is just something that can be my activity to play through the system. Others were longer as fun. There was one comment that said, oh my God, awesome. If you help me, I think these students interact with one of the types of people like yours, who are different styles and different economic values. So it's also a question that great spirit, you know, is a response to that. How does it work with the way you play through your life? You know, it's a great system. So when I saw this, I thought, I'm happy to see that this is another way that I felt like a fluency of my own. Well, my spirit wasn't just distracted with someone else's world, but created your own vision, your own world, and participated constantly in part of the community with their collaborative building things together. So I really saw this, in my mind, it's not enough just to be interacting, but even becoming engaged. The word of God's basis is a public becoming this ministry. It very well might be a very engaging game to take some hours with. And there might even be learning something with them. But in my mind, we need to regenerate this interaction and engagement to really create a space, inspiring people to develop their own voice, to let them feel good and express their own ideas. And in my mind, that also is going to help them into a playful experience. The word of Christ is done based on the purpose of it, might be a family, might seem playful. But for me, the essence of play is that you keep testing the boundaries, trying new things, experiment, taking risks, and through the creative experience, it's a fun release to develop. So I think the spirit of really wanted to be, I think for me, the main message of the warrior type story is that there are multiple paths that we can go down with educational media and educational technologies. This is not just one track. It's really important to go into this, whether it's designers or educators or veterans, with our eyes open to how, you know, different pathways to do it. Just try to think about which of these tools, which of these technologies, which of these activities will enable people to express themselves to design and create things. So it's those with style, through those with all types of technologies, Thank you. including the plan. So what is it that they're looking at? Some things are obvious. You know, there are certain computations that can make an idea. But what is variable to the story that it's all about the whole of the computer program? It goes much beyond that. I think we see if you look at what all the young people are doing in the story that is coming, you see that they were developing strategies for problem solving and design. I think created their project, that we were able to take complex problems, complex problems, and make them just a simple approach. They were able to iteratively refine their ideas to continue to improve what they were working on for their design project. They learned how to reuse and reinvent what others had done, like building software for work of others. They learned how to identify bugs or problems and how to fix them. Now, these are useful skills not just in programming, but in everything that we're doing. All of us are engaged in design activities, whether technologically based design, no matter what you grow up with, grow up to do, whether you grow up to be community organizer or a marketing manager, or a journalist or a politician, everyone needs to design and create things. And these types of problem-solving design skills that you can program are useful in everything you end up doing, not just in programming. But I think there's one other dimension of what design is like to play with these crowds that maybe is even more important. And that can be sometimes called what we do for sponsors. So these are new ways of seeing the world in which I'm living. These are new ways of seeing yourself. We see this young people voting and driving. It gives them new ways for thinking for certain things in the world. They start wondering how these things in the world work. Again, we talk about labor minds, but we see the same things. Once you build a robot, they start wondering how other mechanical things in the world work. Once people start voting in comments or other stories, they start wondering and I think it's really important for those of you wondering about and understanding and asking questions as well as being skeptical about the reasons why the world is happening. But also, as people start to see themselves in new ways, they see the world in new ways, and also see themselves in new ways. Maybe what's most important, they start to see themselves as creators. They start to see themselves as people who can do things in the world, who can contribute to the world. It doesn't have just practical importance, but also, as I said earlier, it has a talent effect, and I think it has a political importance of people saying that they can be an active member of today's society. During the last decade, there is, the church is active literacy movement, but an important political dimension. So it is important for one to play, not just to get a job, but for everyone to have an active voice in how their society was led. And that, I think, is the biggest way forward. And how it is to see themselves as a creator, so they can become the participants and see themselves as a team of participants in the world around them. And to start developing those ideas as creative thinkers. So I think we really believe, as I think we do, as we talk to you every year, that the world continues to accelerate this pace of change. We are so confident that to make sure that creators, your children, grow up, as creative thinkers, they're ready to be full participants. From my understanding, I think it could be more important as we start to think about the goals of new technologies and the lives of people, is how we can develop technologies in a way that gives everybody the ability to create a thinker, so they become active participants in tomorrow's society. Hopefully, this will come back and benefit. I very much like to point out a few things where you can follow up as you can use these ideas, how you can go further and follow up with these ideas and make this happen. My former grad student, Lauren Grant, who's now a professor at Harvard Grad School of Education, started planning a website for the Scholarship Opportunity for grad scholars, specifically an online community for educators who are helping other people learn with grads and learning to code. And together with Tyler, to sell some of these ideas about coding to learning, to the different things that young people learn as they code, and different ways of discussing what people learn as they code. So if you're interested in the way things are into how and what people learn as they code is how to respect and support young people as they learn to code, I encourage you to go to the Scholarship website and join. I also encourage you to go to your business, as I mentioned before, the other conversation afterwards about the upgrade and discussion, if you stay And then this afternoon, at 2:45, I was doing a workshop with Tyler and I at the gym. This is a workshop called Practical Prayer Formula. I think it's an introduction to Scratch. We are going to actually try out Scratch, start doing things, but also we'll be discussing how to go different from Scratch and to use the practice, and how you might use Scratch and code to go to the Sabbath. If it's something new for me, the timing and the guidance that the religious schedule for my day, we're looking at the afternoon things that we are in workshop and starting to force products. If you're interested, as mentioned before, just go to the registration and down to the bottom floor. So, when you come to the workshop or a conversation or follow up about this process, I really hope that you can join with us and just continue to support these ideas. So, these are ideas that are important. We're working hard on the neighborhood and I think we're a very small group. Really influence the mindsets of people around the world to support people, to recognize and support and help you help their parents, but then we all need to join together. So I hope that all of you can all join together and help support them to provide their faith and help everybody be informed.